guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking brows and how I do my brows on a regular basis and how you can actually do different kind of brows. Because trust me, if you've not been filling your brows, you don't know the kind of difference it actually makes to your entire face. Like, it gives your face that structure, you know. Otherwise your face literally looks a little flat, like right now. Now there are a lot of ways to fill in and shape your brows, like right from your everyday you know, brow look, to just like feathery brows, to your proper Instagram brows and stuff. So I'm gonna be covering all of that in today's video. We're literally just focusing on brows today, you guys. Like, just talking brows. Honestly, it's been a little more than a year since I actually went to a salon to get my brows done. And I used to at one point have a unibrow, just saying, but I don't know, for some reason, like, my hair growth has just, like, it's just stopped. So I just, like, randomly get like a few hairs here and sometimes, like, you know, on the edges and stuff. So normally I just use the face razor that I have and I just, like, you know, take off the extras that I get here and there. And I'm also going to be doing that because it's been a while and I do have some extra hair around this area. Also, if you notice carefully, my brows are not identical, like, they're not twins for sure. This one is a little teda and this one is like 2C double. So yeah, it takes a little bit of effort to make them look identical. But yeah, without any further ado, let's get into the video. Alrighty guys, let's get started. So first I'm gonna shape my brows using the face razor that I generally use. Now you guys can also go ahead and you know, thread your brows, as I said, but this is what I generally do because it's easy, it's less messy, and it's just faster. What I like to do is just widen the gap. Obviously, if you do not wish to do that, it's completely your call. Like, you do you, girl. Like, whatever suits you, okay? And I'm not taking off a lot, just like one line. Also, if you're doing this for the first time, you want to keep your hands very steady because one tiny slip and that is it, bro. Like, game over. For the scar part, I generally just take off the excess from the bottom. Now this is about your basic shape, okay? And now moving on to how you fill in your brows, I'm going to show you three different variations of how I fill in my brows. And for that, I'm going to be using the Lakmé pencils. Now these are very newly launched, but these are like three different variations. And I'm going to be using each of them to show you how to create different style of brows, okay? So the first one is the Micro Brow Perfector. This is what I'm going to be using for the everyday natural brows, where you can actually mimic the brow hair, okay? You don't really have to fill in. You can actually create light feathery strokes between your brow hair to create more thickness in your brows. The one that I'm going to be using is called the Micro Brow Perfector, and they have two shades in this. So this is coffee. It's this nice soft brown color. Okay, very, very natural. You do not have to go for anything which is like black, okay? That just looks very off. And the other one is charcoal, which is going to be a little darker than coffee, but it's going to be a little bit more ash. Okay, so now judging by my brow hair, I think charcoal is what fits me well. Now the basic idea of this micro brow filler is that, you know, if you can see the tip of this pencil right here, it's actually very fine. Okay, so this actually helps in creating nice feathery brow hair between your brows. Okay, now for that everyday look, what I'm gonna do is just use the spoolie end of the brush and I'm gonna brush the brow hair upwards. Okay, and this is just gonna allow me to see all of the gaps so that I can fill in using lighter strokes in between. Okay, now I'm gonna start right from the base of my brows. And I'm not going to create a line here, okay? Because when the minute you do that, it actually looks very, very, like, you know, shaped, artificially shaped. So do not do that when you want to go for that natural look. I'm going to just start from the base here and I'm going to create like upwards strokes, okay? And this is just going to fill in the gaps. At the same time, it's just going to give me that nice, naturally bushy brows, okay? Now in my brow hair, I'm not sure if this is going to be like very visible, but if you've got like very sparse brow hair, this is actually the right way to go about it for your brow so that it doesn't look too much also. Alright, so this is as natural as it can get. You can see the bushiness, the fullness to my brows. At the same time, it doesn't look too much, okay? It looks natural. And I'm going to repeat the same thing on the other side as well. I'm gonna start from bottom. I'm gonna just create nice fine upward strokes. As an additional step, this is completely optional, but to make sure that your brows really look fluffy and like feathered out throughout the day, I'm gonna show you a tiny hack. Now for this trick, what I'm gonna do is just wet the spoolie a little. A soap, you can use whatever soap. And I'm just gonna just get a little bit of that soap, the wax, onto the spoolie. You can use any soap. I'm just gonna push the brow hair upwards. But this is just gonna make sure that your brows look nice and fluffed up throughout the day. It's basically like setting your brow hair in place. This is how your natural, everyday, feathery brows actually look like. Now, they're very easy to do. You can do it on any kind of brows, even if you have like very, very sparse brows. All you need is a micro brow filler kind of a pencil, which is shaped like this, which can give you like nice, very precise brow strokes. And it just actually gives you an illusion of having real brow hair, okay? Because the color also actually sort of matches your brow hair. So you can choose from either the light one or the dark one. Okay, moving on, now I'm gonna show you how you can actually shape your brows and then fill it, giving it a more natural sort of a look, okay? And for that, I'm gonna be using the Lakme Absolute 3D Brow Definer. And this again has actually two shades, so I'm gonna swatch both of them for you. The definer actually comes in this pencil sort of a format, so you can sharpen it, and also it has a spoolie on the other end. And this is shade number one. Okay, it's this nice ashy brown sort of a color, which is called graphite. And the other shade, so yeah, graphite is a bit darker than espresso. Both of them are ashy browns. Okay, I think for my hair, I'm gonna stick to espresso and not graphite, because I think graphite will be a little too dark, because my brows anyway are like really, really dark. Now, this is how you do it. I'm gonna create this nice little border on the base of my brow hair. This is just gonna give it that nice, you know, sort of a shape. So I'm gonna start from the bottom and never darken this corner, okay? Just always keep it darker around this area. Just leave like one finger space. So I'm not gonna fill in my brows yet. I'm just gonna like give it that nice shape that I want. And I'm gonna go all around. I'm gonna actually create this nice shape underneath. Then I'm not gonna touch this portion. I'm gonna start from here, again leaving like 1.5 finger space. And I'm gonna create an arch on the upside. And you wanna just take like this measurement, where do you get your arch on the other brows? Okay, so I get it around here, and this is where I wanna get it. So I think it's just gonna get that shape really nicely. And then I'm gonna connect it with the end part of it and pull it a little downwards so that I get that nice surface shape. Again, in the front portion, I'm not gonna take it all the way upwards. I'm just gonna fill the base part of it. This is the difference. Obviously, I think there is a huge difference. Okay, I'm gonna just do the exact same thing on the other side. I'm gonna start from the bottom of my brow. After I'm done with that, I'm gonna leave one finger space. I'm gonna start from the top portion. I love how the brow fillers actually fit in, like blend in effortlessly with my brow hair, because I have like really bushy dark brows, and they just look very, very natural. Okay, so this is how you fill in and shape your brows. And actually the shape of the pencil and the size of the filler actually makes a lot of difference. So this is why I'm actually using three different types of pencils to show you how you can create three different, you know, kind of looks with your brows. Moving on to the third kind of brows, I'm gonna show you how to do Instagram brows, which are really nicely filled and shaped, and you can also sharpen it using a concealer. And for that, I'm gonna be using the Precision Eyebrow Artist Pencil. Now this one comes in a twisty format. Again, it comes in two shades. So this is how it looks like. Although, as you can tell, the tip is a little thicker and there is an angle to it. Like it's got this nice angled thick tip. It is dark brown. This is how it looks like. And the other shade that I have is slightly ashy and it's called Natural Black. Kind of a tip will actually help you in two ways. You can actually use the pointy edge of it to create like fake brow hair kind of strokes. Then you can use the rest of the pencil to create, to fill in the brows, okay, to like darken the center portion of your brow hair. I'm gonna start from the bottom and I'm gonna use the pointy end of it to create this nice, sharp, very precise line. Then I'm gonna create like nice, soft, feathery strokes in the front using the tip of the pencil. And then I'm gonna do the exact same thing that I did before. I'm gonna fill in the top portion, create a nice arch using the sharpened part of it. Just gonna like now fill in the brow hair in place. Also, this one has a little bit of waxy texture, which helps in setting your brow hair in place. So you don't really have to use any wax or any gel to set your brow hair. I'm gonna take a little bit of concealer and I'm gonna take this nice pointy brush which I have here. This is like a concealer brush. And I'm gonna start from the bottom, basically clean the edges out so that I get this nice sharp Instagram kind of brows. And you have to be like really careful while doing this, but it's so satisfying to actually clean the edges out and like make your brows look really nice. So this is it, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was informative enough, and all of the products that I've used are mentioned in the description box below. So first things first, as I said, please identify the kind of brows you have, because some people have absolutely like very, very sparse brows, and in that case you have to go for something which helps in creating your brow hair, okay? On the other hand, if you just need something to fill in your brows, you require a different kind of pencil. All the three different types of pencils that you require I have shown you all, and these products are mentioned in the description box below. You guys can check them out. So that is it for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it helpful. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel before you leave. And that is it for now. I'll see you next time. Bye.